was one of our green teams and want to know what to do next. I wasn't sure what to tell them. What do you think?
I think it's time for a more robust set of best practices and an assessment and rating system that really links our climate action plan to what's happening on campus.
I think that's a great idea.
Hi, I'm Jim Mignano from the Oregon Center for Career Development in Childhood Care and Education. The green team here was actually founded as a kind of response to the climate champions call. Our staff has always been pretty conscious about how to kind of reduce our environmental impact and sustainable practices. But when we found out about the Climate Champions program and the green teams, we really found a way to kind of make our efforts more tangible and institutionalized around the department and kind of connect ourselves, like our individual actions and our departmental actions, with what's going on in the wider community, be it at the university level or city level or even worldwide.
Hi, I'm Sarah from Transportation and Parking, and I represent the Auxiliary Services Green Team. We started our green team about 3 years ago, and we have about 8 members right now.
Hello, Campus Sustainability Emergency Hotline. What's the nature of your emergency?
People in my office are throwing light bulbs and used batteries into the compost bin.
So this is our break room. We have some reusable dishes and silverware that people can use. We also have reusable dish towels. We have a special recycling, and we also collect the caps and lids so that we can make sure to recycle those. And then we have some information up top so that people are doing things right. We collect our plastic bags. They often don't make it to the recycling because people actually take them home and reuse them. We've been composting ever since we moved into this space, and we have a guide so everybody knows what can be composted. I think we should focus a little bit more on gathering some data in terms of energy use, purchasing practices, paper use.
This is our trip journal, and people can access this from their desktop. You can select exactly how you got to work and back that day. And all of the results at the end of the period are automatically tabulated. Just over 30% of our trips are single occupancy vehicle, and that was actually in December. So this was our baseline. And what we're trying to do is by, I think it's 2015, get that down to less than 20%.
Yes. My coworkers, there's an open gasoline fire and they're putting plastic on it. What should I do?
Hi.
Hi, I'm Connie Blumfeld. And I purchase office supplies. For the last 4 or 5 years, whenever possible, I've used the reuse recycle room. I make sure that everything that we purchase is 100% recycled. If I run short of a supply, sometimes I'll just put out a email to everybody and say, we seem to be short of pens. Have you got excess stored in your desk, or do I need to reorder this? And it's amazing how many pens will appear. The toners are reused. So we just try to be conscientious. Reuse, recycle as much as we can.
Tray here, one of our printers carries, well, not just recycle, but the back sheets of previously used paper.
Everyone in my office leaves their computers on all night and over the weekend too.
But remote power management settings from OIT that shut down the computers or put them on standby after, I believe it's 5 minutes of inactivity. If they leave their desk for, you know, a few minutes, they come back, they actually have to log back in. So what happens is you have a secure workstation, so you don't have to worry about it.